we are asked to simplify the given expressions. To simplify the expressions, we must combine like terms. Like terms are terms that have the exact same variable factors, meaning the same variables with the same exponents. Constant terms are also like terms. To combine like terms, we add the coefficients. The variable factors remain the same. The first given expression is 5x plus 8 plus 4x plus 7. Notice 5x and 4x contain exactly one factor of x, which means 5x and 4x are like terms. And the constant terms 8 and 7 are also like terms. When combining like terms, it can be helpful to rewrite the expression with the like terms next to each other. Let's do this. The given expression is equivalent to the expression 5x plus 4x plus 8 plus 7. Notice now we have the x terms next to each other and we have the constant terms next to each other. Looking at the x terms, because 5 plus 4 is equal to 9, 5x plus 4x equals 9x, and 8 plus 7 is equal to 15, the expression simplifies to 9x plus 15. For b, we are given the expression 6y squared plus 12y plus y squared. The coefficient of y squared is 1. Let's write plus y squared as plus 1y squared. Having the coefficient of 1 will be helpful when combining like terms. And then we have minus 3y. In this expression, the terms 6y squared and 1y squared are like terms because both terms contain two factors of y, or a factor of y squared. And the terms 12y and negative 3y are also like terms because they both contain one factor of y. Let's write the like terms next to each other. It's common to write the terms of an expression in descending order, meaning we order the terms using the exponents, and we order the terms from the highest exponent to the lowest exponent. The given expression is equivalent to 6y squared plus 1y squared plus 12y minus 3y. Notice now we have the y squared terms next to each other, and we have the y terms next to each other. Combining like terms, looking at the y squared terms, because 6 plus 1 equals 7, 6y squared plus 1y squared equals 7y squared. Looking at the y terms, because 12 minus 3 is 9, 12y minus 3y is 9y, giving us the simplified expression 7y squared plus 9y. Again, these terms are in descending order because we have the degree 2 term first, followed by the degree 1 term. And then for c, we are given the expression 4z squared plus 4z plus 2. Let's write minus z squared as minus 1z squared. And then we have plus 5 minus 4z plus 2z cubed. Let's identify the like terms. Notice there are no like terms with 2z cubed because there are no other terms that have exactly three factors of z or a factor of z cubed. Looking at the z squared terms, here we have 4z squared and negative 1z squared. These two terms are like terms. Looking at the z terms, we have 4z and negative 4z. Those two terms are like terms. And we also have the constants 2 and 5, which are like terms. Let's write the expression with the like terms next to each other. And let's also write the terms in descending order. So the first term is going to be 2z cubed. Now we'll write the degree 2 terms, or the z squared terms. So we have plus 4z squared, and then minus 1z squared. Looking at the z terms, we have plus 4z minus 4z. Finally, we have the constant terms, plus 2 plus 5. Now we have the z squared terms next to each other, the z terms next to each other, and the constants next to each other. Combining like terms, The simplified expression will have 2z cubed. Now looking at the z squared terms, because 4 minus 1 is 3, 4z squared minus 1z squared is 3z squared. We have plus 3z squared. Looking at the z terms, because 4 minus 4 is 0, 4z minus 4z is 0z, which equals 0. Looking at the constant terms, 2 plus 5 is 7, giving us plus 7. The simplified expression is 2z cubed plus 3z squared plus 7. I hope you found this helpful.